The high tower of the Roman Catholic Cathedral of Westminster is a landmark of London. It rises 284 feet from the land that was once a marsh on the River Thames, reclaimed by the Benedictine monks who built the first abbey of Westminster half a mile away. If you come to the top platform of this tower, a vast and splendid view of London lies before you. I can look now to the north, over the clustered buildings of government in Whitehall, the open sweep of Horse Guards Parade, St. James's Palace, and Nelson standing at the top of his column in Trafalgar Square below us. Beyond him, over the huddled rooftops of the West End of London, are the trees of Regent's Park, and further still, the outlying heights of Hampstead and Highgate. Now turn slowly clockwise through the east. There's the dome of St. Paul's Cathedral and all the crowded church spires of the city. London River winds through the maze like a silver streak on its way down to the Kent and Essex flats and the sea. Even to a Londoner, this view from Westminster is breathtaking. This bell tower seems to dwarf everything that lies round it. Even Parliament and Big Ben seem no more than ordinary, and the bustle and the noise of London are reduced to that faint throb of life that always rises day and night from the capital. This huge building, brick-built in the Byzantine style, has in it something of St. Mark's in Venice and something of the Santa Sophia in Constantinople. It is one of Britain's newest cathedrals, for it has stood here only 50 years. Its building, begun by Cardinal Vaughan in 1895, took only 7 years. And yet, the Cardinal died just before this tower was finished, and the first public religious service held here was his requiem. The main entrance is in the form of a great archway, and on it is the inscription, Domine Jesu Rex et Redemptor, per sanguinem tuum salva nos. Lord Jesus, King and Redeemer, save us by thy blood. If you stand in the nave, you'll see the 8 columns of dark green marble which support it. They were hewn from the very quarry which yielded to Justinian 1400 years ago the green marble for Santa Sophia. High Mass is sung today at Westminster. The celebrant is the Very Reverend Monsignor Canon C. Collingwood. The deacon is the Reverend T. Kilcoyne, and the subdeacon, the Reverend R. Shepherd. Mr. Maxwell Fernie is the organist, and William Hyde, the choirmaster. The celebrant will preach the sermon.
We shall move to heaven. Oh. et veniat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.